This report covered World Bank Group engagement in upper middle income countries. Out of over 180 countries that are part of the World Bank Group, about 100 are middle income countries. These countries constitute about one-third of the global GDP, and they are home to about 70% of the poor of the world. And the World Bank is an important partner for many of them. An interesting detail with the middle income countries is that many of them do not require the same amount of World Bank Group financing as before. Overall, we found that although there is a trend of diminishing demand for the World Bank Group financing, all of these countries really value World Bank Group partnership. And the World Bank played an important role in helping them to cope with the consequences of financial, economic, and humanitarian crisis, help them to build public sector institutions, promote private sector investments, and so on. However, we also found that despite many success stories, the systemic engagement of the World Bank Group, especially on strengthening the public sector and improving innovation and competitiveness of the private sectors in these countries, was not really there. So there is a real need to look at it as a systemic issue and address it the same way. We also found that there's still a big gap between upper middle income countries' performance in terms of the quality of their public sector institutions and private sector competitiveness vis-a-vis the group they look forward to joining, the high income countries. And that's a big challenge that is still there, and the World Bank should be there to help to address those challenges. A few things probably are worth mentioning. One of them is that there is a huge potential for South-South cooperation and knowledge transfer. And although there's a few examples of that, especially from upper middle income countries to lower income countries or lower middle income countries, there's still a huge space for improvement in that area. And the World Bank can play an instrumental role there. Also, there's a clear need for the World Bank to think in the direction of expanding the choice and menu of its financial instruments it can offer to such an important group of clients as upper middle income countries.